Hey everyone, it's Jenny at JC Cards. I hope you're all having a wonderful day.
Today my video focuses on emboss resist using watercolours. I think this is probably my favourite form of emboss resist. It's super quick and easy, you get some amazing effects. I've got four different card examples to show you today and they all use different watercolour mediums. So to get started, I'm going to be using this Hero Arts Holiday Foliage.
I've taken the mouse pad out of my Misti because this is a red rubber stamp. And then I'm going to be using my Misti just to make sure that I can double stamp this background. I'm using watercolour cardstock. It's cold press, Canson XL watercolour cardstock. And this is a very intricate stamp, but I always recommend using a Misti with watercolour cardstock, particularly when heat embossing. So you can do that double stamp and get a really good impression. So I've treated my cardstock with a powder tool just to make sure I don't get any embossing powder sticking where I don't want it. And then I'm going to stamp the image twice. I only show it once, but twice with Wow embossing ink. For all of my cards today, for the emboss resist background, I'm using opaque bright white embossing powder by Wow. You can of course use any colour of embossing powder that you want to use. Gold is really good for emboss resist and silver, all of the neutral colours. I love superfine white though, especially with a design like this, which is really detailed. The superfine grade powder is probably the best for it. And then I'm going to heat it up with my heat tool. You can't really see much right now because it's white on white, but when you add that medium, it will really bring to life that background image. So for my first watercolour medium, I'm using these watercolour brush markers from Alter New. The reason I wanted to use these with this background stamp in particular is because you can use them in a quite a targeted way, very similar to using a paintbrush and watercolour tubes or pans. So whilst I've maintaining a sketchy feel here, I do want to colour in a couple of the images that are in this background stamp. So you'll see my technique, I've sped it up quite a lot here. I'm sort of scribbling on some of the paint directly from the water brush marker, scribbling it around a bit, pulling it out a little bit with a water pen, just pulling it out so it fades away down towards the edges at the bottom and the right hand side of that panel. I don't want to cover the entire piece of cardstock, I want to leave some areas white. I'm then going to dry it on setting one on my heat tool, and then when it's dry I'm going to come back in again. So I've come back in with a yellow colour and then some brown where there are pine cones in the images. And then I'm going to pull it out again with my water brush. I do go in with a Nuvo shimmer pen in Midas Touch, which is gold, just to add a really subtle bit of sparkle. It's impossible to see it in the video, but you can see it in real life. And then I dry it again, go back in, tap off some of the excess water. And the reason I'm doing this layering effect is it gets some nice kind of edges in this sketchy feel. As you dry the water, as it bleeds and then dries, it leaves a nice kind of edge. And you also get some more intense colours in the wells that are created by the embossing against some more paler colours, and it gives this really nice textured look to it, and I really, really like it. So I'm just going to finish it off. I've done three or four layers, I think, on this one card, and you could do this with any background stamp and any colours, but I was going for a kind of Christmassy vibe, sort of towards the end of autumn. Moving into winter now, aren't we? Sadly, unfortunately. So I've dried it for the last time. I've trimmed it down to fit on the front of an A2 note card. And then just to finish it off, I've die cut this thanks die. This is by Tailored Expressions. Once from some yellow fun foam. This is by Doris. And then once from some gold glitter cardstock that I picked up at Michael's. But you could, of course, if you wanted to, create your own glitter cardstock using Wow Sparkles, which I've done in the past as well. And then I'm going to adhere those together and pop it up onto my card. As a finishing touch, I'm going to add some Nuvo Jewel Drops. These are limoncello because I thought the yellow would tie in nicely to that subtle yellow and green background. And I'm just going to add them in a few places. If you get any of those spikes on the top of your drop, just tap the background a few times and that should flatten them out a little bit. And here's a close-up. Now for my next card, I'm going to be using the Leaves and Berries Background by Simon Says Stamp. You might have seen this in my video last week. I really love this stamp. It's so versatile. It's great. It looks Christmassy, but it's not Christmassy. It's really clever. So I'm heating it up again in opaque bright white embossing powder using the exact same cardstock, exact same technique as we did before. And then this time I'm going to be using some liquid watercolours. I'm using Dr. P.H. Martin's Hydrus, but you could use any liquid watercolours that are out there. There's quite a lot on the market. And I'm using them straight from the bottle. I'm not watering them down before I apply them. I wanted to get more intense colour. And watercolour, for those of you who are familiar with it, does tend to dry back quite a lot, which means it basically fades as it dries. And I was looking for something a bit more intense. Now, of course, you could get that look with other types of mediums, but I'm focusing on watercolour for this video. And I just dropped, with the pipette that was in my liquid watercolours, the watercolour straight onto that embossing. And you can see, as it starts to spread out, that the white embossing powder is resisting that liquid. I am spritzing it with a bit of water from my sprayer bottle just off camera, just to spread out some of those colours. I want to cover the whole background on this one. And then I'm going to dry it on setting one with my heat tool. Tap off any excess onto my craft mat and mop it up as I go. And if it was a bit intense, which you might find it is, or you might want to remove some of the excess paint, you can mop it up with a paper towel. Now for this panel, I'm going to die cut the word joy. I'm lining up these bold alphas from Altenew. These are the lowercase set. As best I can, my O was a little bit wonky, I will say, and I do recommend saving the centre of it when you die cut in a safe place so that you can add it in a little bit later on. And then I'm going to add a stitched rectangle die to make the panel a bit smaller, and that did help with getting my letters a little straighter than they were initially. To add some dimension, I'm going to add some 3M foam tape onto the back and then pop it onto a white note card. And there I've added some foam tape behind that centre of the O. These are three new snowflakes from Simon Says Stamp. I think it's Lee, Grace and Marie. And I have die cut them from that same gold glitter card stock that we used on the thanks die before. And then I'm just going to adhere them from the centre, so not right round the edges. I've only added liquid glue just into the middles and out slightly to allow them to pop up a bit. And where they overhang the card, I'm going to trim them down. And that just adds a little bit of sparkle and bling to that background. And here's a close-up. You can see the intensity of that watercolour in some places that's hard to replicate with other types of watercolour so easily. So I've gone ahead, I'm not going to repeat again the heat embossing part, but I've gone ahead and used that first background stamp that you saw, the Hero Arts one. And this time I'm using watercolour powders. So I've spritzed liberally my background panel with water, and then I'm going to drop some watercolour powders over the top of it before then coming back in with my water. And I did overdo it a little bit on that first squirt, you might have noticed, so I tapped it off into a garbage can. It was a bit of a waste, but it came out a little bit more than I was expecting. I'm using Lilac Waterfall Nouveau Shimmer Powder, which has a little bit of glimmer in it, and the Blue Blitz as well, just in a couple of places. And I added quite a lot of water here. I wanted this to be super pale, and just went in, dried it a couple of times, added the powder in exactly the same way that we did with the liquid watercolours. And when I was done, I trimmed it down, popped it onto a white note card, and I've cut out a smaller piece of vellum, which I'm going to be placing directly over the top of my background. And it won't take away from the background itself. It just slightly tones it down a bit in the centre, so you're not losing any of that gorgeous watercolour in the background. And then I'm going to directly heat emboss into the centre of this vellum with this Simon Says Stamp Holiday Greetings Mix 1 stamp set. I'm using my Wow Embossing ink. I have treated this vellum with a powder tool, and I'm going to heat emboss it with this primary indigo embossing powder, which is really pretty. It goes great on vellum because it is semi-translucent, so it works great on white cardstock, not so great on darker cardstock, it's hard to see, but look at that shine once it's heated up. Now, adhering vellum is always a bit tricky, so I'm using some of those thicker leaves just to add some liquid adhesive behind, and I did add it in a few other places as well. This glue does dry clear, but just to make certain that it can't be seen from the front, I will come in and add some pale pink enamel dots that I just had on my craft desk. And I thought they went really well with some of those colours that come out of the Nuvo Shimmer Powder in that background. And that finishes my third card. I'll give you a close-up of it in just a second. Here you go. You can see it's quite a subtle background, and I just really love how that powder wicks around that embossing. Now for my final card, I'm using this Simisys Stamp Kaleidoscope Leaves background stamp. I've heat embossed it with opaque bright white, exactly the same as before. And this time I'm going to be using Distress Inks to do my watercolouring. I know they're not quite technically paints, but they're great for using for watercolour. And I'm smushing them down on my craft mat. I'm using a bunch of yellows and reds and oranges. I've got Abandoned Coral, Carved Pumpkin, Fossilized Amber, and Caramelized Apple, and I'm spritzing them with water whilst they're on the craft mat, letting it bead up and then dipping in my embossing card panel, and it'll just resist that ink. And then I'll dry it with my heat tool, do it again, do it a couple more times, and then as a finishing touch I'm going to be flicking on some water droplets just for my hand, as you saw there, and it will react with that distress ink and leave some really cool effects in and amongst that embossing. To finish my card, I'm using the Fine Alpha Dyes by Altenew, and I'm spelling out the word love. I'm using my craft mat to line these up on some tonic purple tape just to make sure that I do get them straight, a little bit straighter than I got the joy, unfortunately. And then I can pick up that tape and use it to choose where I want to do my die cutting. So I'm just going to have it slightly off to the left down in the corner of the card panel, and then run it through my die cutting machine. Once again, being sure to retain that center of the O in a safe place. And I'm going to do what I did before, which was use my 3M foam tape to add some dimension and add strips to the back, and make sure that I also add a little bit to that back of that center of the O. And for a little bit of sparkle, I've added some Phoenix sequins that coordinate perfectly with those distress inks. And that finishes my fourth card. If you enjoyed this video, you might like a few others that I have on my channel and over on the Wow Embossing YouTube channel as well, featuring different techniques using embossing powders. I've added a couple of videos that you might like here, and it'd be great if you consider subscribing to my channel. Don't forget to hit that bell to be reminded when I have a new video. Have an awesome day. Bye.